Yeah. Mariano Ojeda wants to know, would you like to put Brandon against Lucas Matisse?
Brandon already said it, that Brandon, after this fight and everything goes well, he wins, that's what he wants. He's gonna call out Lucas Matisse. He will love that fight too. Brandon just loves to fight. Brandon loves to fight, and Lucas Matisse does too, so it would be a hell of a fight.
But of course, the promoters, until that, it's a great entertaining fight, but probably won't see it.
Won't see it. We'll probably see Maidan against Matisse before we see Brandon against
Matisse. That's a very entertaining fight,
that
too.
Would be a good
that will sell out a stadium, I think, in Argentina.
A soccer stadium.
A water?
Kim Torres, which boxer has the best shot in MMA?
Boxers, best shot in MMA? They also go by weights in MMA, right?
Yeah.
Depends on what weight they're talking about. If they're talking about like a welterweight division like the Mayweather, then I say Mayweather. If they're talking about the heavyweight division, who the fuck is a good heavyweight that maybe has a shot? Klitschko.
You don't think the Klitschkos would have a chance as big as they are?
No, they used to be kickboxers, you're right. They could kick.
Yeah, that's a plus there.
Yeah. They actually used to be big fans of Bruce Lee. They had their posters in Rocky.
Then that's them.
The whole family lived in one bedroom. The bathrooms were outside.
Hey, I haven't seen it, but I've been flipping channels and I see something on HBO on the Klitschkos.
Yeah,
is that them?
It's the longest documentary you will ever watch in your life.
Oh, but is that them?
Yeah, I went to see it.
Is it about them?
Yeah, it's about them.
Oh, then I got to check it out because I haven't seen it.
I went to see it the night it aired, especially for the Klitschkos and their friends.
Is it okay?
Yeah. It's long, but it's interesting, but you keep thinking the movie ends and it keeps going.
Robert Combs, just wants you to know that you're good people and to continue doing what you're doing.
Thanks, buddy. What's his name?
Robert Combs.
Robert, thank you.
Tocayo.
Tocayo.
El Juan wants to know, what's your favorite beer?
When I have a beer, it's always Bud Light. I don't like to drink heavy, Bud Light.
Like a power roll.
Bud Light.
Where is he?
He's been gone. I don't know. When I do drink beer and I don't do it that often, it's Bud Light.
So Robert, what do you say about 10, 15, 20 years ago, if you wanted to do this and take questions from fans, they would have to send you letters. It would take a week to get here, 2 weeks to get back. And now, from all over the world, within seconds, you get the craziest questions.
So advanced.
But what do you think about your fans? They're knowledgeable?
Fucking awesome, dude. Fucking awesome.
How are you doing?
They're asking me what beer I like to drink.
They want to know what to buy for you when they see you.
Yeah,
they ask you which celebrity you think is the hottest if they see her, you know?
I'm working, I don't know.
Who's the hottest celebrity?
Dwight Howard.
Who's that supposed to be?
Dwight
Howard. That's the hottest celebrity, Dwight Howard.
That was a good one.
Dwight Howard.
The new superstar of the Lakers, right?
Even though they lost.
He and Shaquille O'Neal were talking smack to each other this week.
You should have seen who was in. Some white guy, something Nelson. That guy sucks ass. Hey, they had their start. The other team had their start. Golden State had their start like the whole game. We put in some guy, something Nelson. That guy sucked. They missed two free throws, airballed one of them. Suck. Who else put in?
But why is he in the team?
No, because they're cutting players. They have 20 people. They have to cut five. They're cutting that team. That guy sucked ass. Then Darius Johnson, Odom, he's all right.
I asked before who's the biggest Kobe Bryant fan in the building, and everybody said,
is he? I'm not the biggest Kobe fan. I'm a Laker fan. Kobe just happens to be on the team.
Kobe's retiring in 2 years.
I'm still gonna be a Laker fan. Dwight Howard.
But it's cool.
I don't know.
So Pelos already had two weigh-ins with Gato, right? This will be the third?
Is it? No, the one
weigh-in with Gato.
Yeah, the other one was just a few days, like maybe a week.
Yeah, I think it was a week.
But it's a good opportunity for Pelos, for Brandon, for Nonito, for all the young guys.
The Russians are a good fight.
Yeah, Russian.
Does he have a promoter yet?
I'm not sure if he signed with Top Rank, but Top Rank's the one getting got him the last fight in this one, so
he could be a world champion.
Yeah, he can.
Too.
I think so. I really think so. Probably beat Billy Dib.
in Russian.
How did he get to your gym? Because everybody else kind of like they know, but he came out of nowhere.
His Russian manager called me one day.
Lithuanian, not Russian. Lithuanian. Don't call him Salvadorian or Puerto Rican.
Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, well, his manager called me one day and said he was going to send him over here. And then I was in, I told him, you know, Doc tries to take care of the hotel and all that. So I was at some fights and the doctor told me, hey, you know who this Russian is? I'm like, no. He's like, well, his manager and him, they're here saying that they talked to you. Okay, so they put him in the hotel.
Yeah. And he came here with no English?
He's going to school.
Going to school, he grabbed the car.
Yeah.
He found the other Russian, the law of Ventura County. He found two Russians, the post office guy and a guy in class.
Oh, yeah?
And the guy in class is from...
Now he's got friends.
Yeah? Why not? He's a good dude.
Yeah,
he works hard.
Works hard. Hard.
I think the hardest thing for a fighter is the weight. Everything else is easy. But he maintains his weight. He doesn't...
So year round, he's eating healthy. He's finding, he's staying in shape. Year round.
And he's learning. He's learning all the local street smarts.
Yeah. No, he's very talented, and he's got a good future. If his manager keeps doing the right thing, he's got a bright future.
And then I talked to Akeem. He told me he's fighting this weekend and next weekend.
Yeah. Yeah, both Saturdays in a row.
So is McCombie, isn't
it? McCombie.
They just want to be busy towards the end of the year?
They need to, man. They haven't fought in a long time.
What about Canelo, the white Canelo?
Vinny.
Oh, Vinny? I don't know. Cameron said something, but I can't remember what he said about him. I think we're going to have him here soon again.
And what about the guy from New York, Chris Algieri?
Chris Algieri? I think he's coming up in the next couple of weeks or something.
And then if you have any other surprise fighters that may come by, it's going to be a great next year.
Chavo Jr.
Finish the year strong.
Can't wait for next year. Got to get, you know, the fights are getting tougher, man. Maidana is going to get a tougher fight, and then Kylie gets a tougher fight. Brandon's going to get tougher fights after this one.
Hello,
Velo there. Insane, man.
Tyson Marquez?
Exactly, yeah. Next year could be fucking hard year. A lot more work.
You're not going, huh? What did he need to do to be able to go? What was it?
No, nothing anymore.
He needs to keep the past.
Chores at home, dude. It's so easy. They just don't do them.